getting on to God, was always kind of ahead of my life. I want to salute a couple people, especially my family, a lot of parts of the Albers, and other names in the family, and all there. My family. We're blessed to be a part of something bigger than ourselves. In reference to my family, to all the people from around the world who have sent condolences and prayers, and I just want to say thank you. I want to say thank you to Kyle and Danielle for giving us, this world, the gift of faith. 21 years, this isn't a long time, but even if it's full life, full enough to reach the world. One of my earliest memories of AI, because Daniel and Kyle have this tendency of giving their children unique names. He told me what his name meant. And he could have been over 5 or 6 something years old. I just remember being grown, like, what does your name mean? And he told me. And I got a 5-year-old. And I indirectly named him because I wanted him to be able to tell everybody what his name meant. And it not just named after a car or a drink or but I wanted him to know what his name meant. I named him Jahari. And for the church folks, that means child of God. But he told me, Phelan means warlike man of destiny. I remember being on Facebook the other day and looking at his face the day before his birthday. I'm like, no, you don't have a free though. But he made it look good. And I was like, oh, man, his birthday tomorrow. I made the note of calling and then he looked and watched him on Facebook. And I read that message over and over again, and I was hoping that I was dyslexic or something because it just didn't make sense. The first 100 times I read. But thank you, Kyle and Daniel. The Lockharts. For giving me my first magazine subscription. My mother sent me over there and said, go see Aunt Priscilla. She'll help you. And she got me together. And I went on to sell a bunch of every magazine subscription that year. And it won some nice prizes. But I love you. I do. I prepared a piece that I seriously, I want to go so many different places with it. Out of anger, out of God, why? But Kalea posted his last text. And that's where I drew this piece from. I don't know if any of you all heard or saw it or whatever, but this last text said, blessed to be 21. Everything counts from here. 21. Saying blessed. Not turned up. Not yellow. Not out popping bottles. Blessed. His name. Warlike man of destiny. He who sees deeply. The rest of what I'm about to say is to all those Heights people, all the Shell people, all the Cleveland people, all the world people that are his age, younger, just a little bit older. We've grown, we lost people. But I worked in education. And then remember Danielle bringing him to the schools I worked at and fighting my students off. No, you can't date my cousin. No, we can't have nothing. And got crossed up so much faith, I think, of faith. Because I just knew he was going to be in the NBA. He made me what they call now a spot shooter, because I can't keep up on the court. Everything counts from here. I watch students lose family members, friends, and they go the opposite way. They stop wanting to learn. They stop wanting to grow. They stop wanting to be more. But for that person that you lost, don't dishonor their life by throwing your life away. Because if they were still here, they would want you to succeed. Everything counts from here. If you black sheep of the family, we all got it. Guess what? Black is that end. Everything counts from here. Go apologize. And don't expect them to keep the door wide open for you. But apologize. Get your family right. Because that's what this did for our family. We've already a strong foundation. But we need to be stronger now. I'm not giving the killers, the thugs, the joy of destroying my family. Don't give them the joy of destroying your future. Everything counts from here. Go to school. Finish. Start something. Finish. Because everything starts from here. What else would they have wanted? When you see my family, when you see Daddy in Ohio, years from now, tell them how you made it count from here. We don't cry. I want to cry now. But this has made me committed. This is that year, New Year's resolution. Since everything counts from here, let your new rest of your life, whether it be 21 more years, 21 more hours, 21 more days, let everything count from here. From here, I am committed. I'm a part of the fellowship of the unashamed. I have Holy Spirit powers. The die has been cast. I stepped out over the line. The decision has been made. I won't look back. Let up, slow down, back away, or be still. My past is redeemed. My present makes sense, and my future is secure. I am finished with low living, sight walking, small plans, smooth knees for my praying, colorless dreams, tame vision, worldly talking, cheap giving, and dwarf goals. I'm no longer in need of privilege, prosperity, position. I need my glasses. Make everything count from here. My pace is set. My gait is fast. My goal is heavy. My road is narrow. My walk is rough. My companions are few. Make everything count from here. I cannot be bought, compromised, detoured, ignored, away, turned back, diluted, or delayed because I make everything count from here. I will not flinch in the face of adversity, negotiate at the table of my enemies, ponder at the pool of popularity or banter in the maze of mediocrity. I won't give up because everything counts from here. I'm prayed up, preached up, for the cause of Christ, I am a disciple of Jesus. I must go till he comes, give till I drop, preach till all is known, and work till he stops me. And when he comes to get his own, he will have no problem recognizing me because I made everything count from here. My colors will be clear. No one can judge me anymore. Only in Jersey because he saw that I made everything count from here. I didn't write this whole thing. Bela, Kalea, thank you. Because it was your strength that you all have been exhibiting since this happened has been the foundation for me. As I'm holding it together physically, you all are holding it together, and I know what you're holding is I can't, I don't want to lean on you.